On July 18, 2024, at 9:50 p.m. local time, a major magnitude 7.4 earthquake struck beneath a 16,000-foot elevation mountainous region of northeastern Chile. As the ground shook for several dozen seconds, many items were knocked off of shelves, hundreds of thousands of people were awoken, and liquefaction was modeled to have likely occurred in multiple areas. The largest population center in the area of heavy ground shaking was the city of Calama, home to 180,000 people and 134 kilometers west-northwest of the quake epicenter. Yet, despite the fact that Chile's largest earthquake in 8 years had just happened, the resulting damage was surprisingly light. The main reason for this lack of damage was the depth the earthquake occurred at. Generally speaking, the shallower an earthquake occurs at, the more damage it causes. Yet, in the case of this Chilean earthquake, it occurred not shallow in the crust, but instead deep in the upper mantle at depths of 117.4 kilometers or 72.9 miles. As a result, while shaking was felt over a broader area, it was less intense than it would have been at shallower depths. Thus, the current model provided by the U.S. Geological Survey suggesting between 1 in 10 fatalities and 10 in 100 million U.S. dollars in damage may be incorrect. So, why did this earthquake occur? The magnitude 7.4 earthquake which struck was a classic example of an intraslab earthquake being centered on the slab of a Nazca plate in the upper mantle, which is subducting underneath the South American plate. Due to the fact that many lighter minerals in the subducting slab experience partial melting, and the fact that increasing pressure occurs at increasing depths this slab gets denser and denser. The denser it gets, the more it sinks into the mantle, meaning deeper sections of the slab are pulled downwards at higher rates than shallower sections. This creates a form of extension, which causes stress to build up until it causes a normal fault to rupture on the slab and accommodate some of this movement. 8 magnitude 7 range and 1 magnitude 8 range earthquakes have occurred in the vicinity in a similar manner at essentially the same depths underneath the Altiplano Plateau since 1950, meaning they seem to occur about once every 8 to 9 years. So, might this earthquake trigger volcanic activity? While it theoretically could, as 18 active or potentially active volcanoes experienced MMI shaking of 5 or greater, this could only theoretically trigger an eruption if a volcano was already primed for a very near future eruption. In other words, while possible, it is highly unlikely, including at the Perico volcano closest to the main shock's epicenter. I estimate that the length of fault rupture which occurred on the underlying Nazca plate was 66.1 kilometers or 41.1 miles. In the next few days to weeks, more aftershocks or earthquakes triggered by the main shock are likely to occur, with a 1 over X frequency compared to the rate of aftershocks on day 1, with X representing the number of days which have passed since the main quake starting with a value of 1. Statistically speaking, the average largest aftershock is 1.2 magnitudes lower than the main quake, which in this case means there is a 50% chance of at least one magnitude 6.2 or larger quake occurring as an aftershock. So far, the largest aftershock was a magnitude 5.0 earthquake which struck 25 minutes after the main quake. As a final note, I would like to thank my new patron Larry Hancock for supporting this channel.